Okay, so this article actually kind of surprised me because when you look at most of these situations, especially with a headline like this one, it usually goes bad and they talk about how video games are pretty much the worst thing that's ever happened. Well, it looks like finally there's at least kind of a break. Which, I know, kind of surprising, right? It was almost like a breath of fresh air seeing this article. Now, of course, I think there's a few things in here that I do want to go ahead and try and contest a little bit, but we talk so much here on the channel about, you know, all these boomer articles essentially coming out and trying to pin a bunch of things on video games when there's not really a reason to be doing it. And of course, you know, the whole video games cause violence argument and all kinds of different ridiculous stuff that has been fueled for decades at this point, they still exist. But articles like this one surprise me because they don't feed into that mentality. And even though that's the way everything kind of looks like it's going with this article, they like actually quote scientific research and talk about some of the positive benefits of video games. So I thought that that was something we should take a look at today to kind of recognize that this happens because it surprised me as well. So I saw this opinion piece on Robbie Ludwig and it was titled, "Are Video Games a Mental Health Hazard for Our Kids?" And I went into this just completely ready for the worst. I was just disappointed that yet again, we had another one of these articles that was just going to be kind of depreciating the value of video games and making a bunch of ridiculous claims that aren't backed by science, but let's go ahead and dive into this one, guys. Are video games placing our kids in danger? Are aggressive video games mentally malevolent and placing the younger generation at risk for long-term mental health problems? The current research results may surprise you. Why? Because the recent findings are a bit more nuanced and complex than you might expect. Video games come in many different forms, but only a few have been studied closely in terms of their effects on the brain. Dr. Daphne Bavillier, something like that, a brain scientist at the University of Rochester and the University of Geneva, researched homicidal first-person shooter games such as Call of Duty. Call of Duty, it's not really a quote-unquote homicidal first-person shooter. It's just like a arcade war-based first-person shooter. I mean, you don't really go around saying that like soldiers in real life are committing homicides. That's usually something kind of reserved for like murder, like actual things. Like, I mean, you could kind of call, say, like GTA a homicidal game. Kind of weird to put that claim on Call of Duty, though. She found that the gamers' brains showed activity in multiple brain regions, showing numerous and surprising visual spatial benefits in such areas as attention, task switching, brain plasticity, learning, short-term memory, perception, and perceptual decision-making skills. Dr. Last Name is not the only researcher who found these types of games encourage a more flexible mindset and faster reaction time than those of non-gamers. And it's kind of weird that just now we're finally seeing articles kind of point this information out because, I mean, this is information that's been available now for God knows how long. It's not like this is brand new information that it can help with your task switching, your attention, your short-term memory, your perception, your hand-eye coordination. This has all been scientifically suggested for a very long time now. But the thing is when people mostly talk about these video games and their effects on the brain and on people and things like that, you never really hear them bring these kinds of things up because you can't really spin this into a negative narrative. You can't spin this into a negative mindset against video games. I mean, if you come out in an article talking about, oh, hey, by the way, video games are the cause of all problems, but by the way, here's all the great benefits that they do provide to people who play them. I mean, you're never going to see anything like that because if you do, it just really, I guess, negates the entire effect of what they're trying to do. But these visual spatial skills being developed can prepare children for future jobs in mathematics, engineering, the natural sciences, economic forecasting, architecture, and as well as careers in art and design, all fields that require visual adeptness. And I would say these are all careers that parents would love for their kids to be in, you know what I'm saying? Of course, you know, what parent isn't like, oh, I want my kid to be a mathematician, or an engineer, or an architect, or a scientist, you know what I'm saying? You ask pretty much any parent on planet Earth, hey, would you be satisfied if your kid got into one of these really high-paying jobs, one of these really secure jobs that are looked upon very highly and are kind of significant in society? You're not going to see most parents out here like, oh no, I don't want that to happen. I don't want my kid to be involved in any of that stuff. But of course, you ask parents, hey, you cool with your kid playing video games? And you're going to have some parents who freak out and act like it's just the worst thing that's ever happened because articles that are on the contrary to this one kind of paint them out to be, once again, just these terror machines that transform your child into an axe-wielding massacre man. You know what I'm saying? So gamers also show higher levels of executive function, which is the ability to make split second decisions. In fact, the new research is at odds with the idea that violent video games make kids less sensitive to violence and/or more likely to commit aggressive acts, which has been something that you've heard about for a long time, right? You hear all the, like, politicians, they love to bring this one up when they're trying to bring in some sort of video game legislature, or when they're trying to blame real-world events on video games because they're just corrupting the youth, right? You hear them talk all about how video games make kids less sensitive to violence because apparently playing Call of Duty means that you can't understand the concept of war. You don't understand or grasp the reality of what's going on behind the video game. Hey, yeah, it's a video game. You're playing Call of Duty World War II. Apparently kids are just less sensitive to the idea that World War II happened, and they're just becoming more and more violent because they're more likely to commit these aggressive acts. It's things that we've heard for a long time. And finally seeing articles where this isn't the case, where they're actually perpetuating correct science, and where they're actually giving the idea that, hey, video games are not as bad as a lot of people think, it's super refreshing. Psychologist Christopher J. Ferguson thinks that the studies linking video games to violence were improperly analyzed and ignored the very important social factors of the mental health status and family environment of the gamers, which is something that I've said before. People talk all about how, oh, video games are problematic. Look at how some of these kids who are really addicted to video games are. And I've literally said this before. It's like, is there maybe a chance that the kid is turning to video games so much that doesn't have to do with the video game? Because like we all understand, right? The vast majority of people who play video games have no problem. They just play video games for fun in their spare time, whatever you want to call it. And it doesn't really become an issue for them. Of course, yes, there's people who get addicted, but people become addicted to anything. And ignoring things like, does the kid have some sort of mental problem going on behind the scenes? Or is the kid's personal life just bad? What's the underlying root cause of the problem? It's something that you don't hear about often enough. It's just, oh, those video games are so addictive, even though they're really not in the grand scheme of things. Those who are considered problematic gamers are more deeply invested in the games, were more at risk than gamers who used games recreationally. The problematic gamers were more likely to be aggressive and show symptoms of being depressed. This study concluded further research analysis should focus more on determining safe ways for kids to consume video games and to intervene if a mental health concern actually does arise. But of course, you know, I don't really like the fact that this one kind of talks about video games like it's some sort of drug. Like, people who use games recreationally compared to people who are extremely addicted to video games and become problematic. Just really weird terminology, because trying to compare a video game to something like crack, it doesn't really work out. It doesn't really shake out to be what you want it to be. But these problematic people who are more likely to be aggressive and whatnot and show signs of depression, once again, showing signs of depression doesn't really have anything to do with the video game. If that person's depressed, they have like an actual mental problem that isn't video game related. It's not like them sitting around playing Grand Theft Auto 5 all day makes them depressed. You know, that just isn't how it works. Kids who use video games as a distraction or to escape life were found to have higher symptoms of lower self-esteem and negative emotions. If a child is happiest online but lacks offline connections, this could encourage a more addictive or problematic usage of video games. Well, of course, people who use all these games and stuff as a distraction or to escape the real life are gonna have all these higher signs of these problems, because why else would they be just diving into video games so badly if they didn't have something else going on? I mean, of course the kid is more likely to say, oh, hey, in this video game world where none of these fucking problems exist, I can just kind of chill out and do whatever I want. Oh, hey, by the way, this is kind of better than how my life's going right now. Why don't I just play video games for 13 hours a day? For anyone that this is surprising, I just have to ask, where have you been throughout all of these other studies and all these other research papers and things that have come out saying this for years now? Having poor psychological functioning is also a risk factor for emotionally problematic video game use. If playing video games prevents a child from developing or practicing good coping skills, finding friends, and/or having a good support system in his or her real life, then playing video games can be potentially harmful. I mean, I don't think I really need to say anything about that. I think we all kind of understand that that can be a problem. But if video game crosses over into an addiction, it can contribute to depression, anxiety, lack of self-control, obsessive compulsive behaviors, and impulsivity in young players. And this is where you're gonna have people screaming like, I told you, Optimus, I told you, bro, video games, they're dangerous. But what addiction doesn't contribute to these kinds of problems? I mean, if you're addicted to eating cardboard boxes with spaghetti sauce on them, I would think, yeah, you'd probably be a little depressed, right? Of course, it's going to create lack of self-control. That's quite literally what addiction boils down to. I mean, if they could control themselves from doing it, they wouldn't necessarily be addicted. Although this research is in its infancy, certain entertainment games have been used to improve mood through stress release, to develop emotional regulation skills, and to develop certain strategic moves that can combat challenging feelings. This is where I want to go ahead and step in and say this research is not in its fucking infancy, okay? These kinds of results have been available for years now. This is not something brand new. It isn't like they came out yesterday and said, oh hey, by the way, it turns out that video games don't actually lead to real life violence, and all the studies that said that they do were based on some sort of fringe characteristic, or they were completely and inexcusably controlled by the people who actually ran the study, so the results are kind of manipulated. It's not like any of this is brand new information. This is things that people like myself have been trying to tell people for a very long time. The video game isn't really your problem. It's the fact that there's an underlying issue creating the problem with video games. The video gaming topic is complex. Can it be problematic for certain kids? Absolutely. Do parents need to observe and evaluate and monitor the impact these games are having on their children? You bet. It is about time, man, that somebody, besides like the very few of us who've been saying this, finally address the elephant in the room. Parents need to be observing what their children are doing and stepping in when there's a problem. I mean, let's be honest, and this is my personal opinion. How do you think these video game addictions start? Like, they just play, I don't know, Minecraft once and they just never can put the controller down again? They have to like try and play video games for 80 hours a day, which, I mean, is impossible. But does that really seem likely? Because if that's the case, the numbers should definitely be a lot higher when it comes down to video game addiction. I feel like a lot of parents and a lot of people, they just buy their kid an Xbox, they slap it down in front of him, and they just step completely out of his life because, oh, well, the video game can babysit him. Oh, he's going to be entertained by this video game console. Now I don't have to pay as much attention to what he's doing. But these games, like almost everything in life, can have a positive or negative impact on one's emotions and mental health. The key is to be acutely aware of the specific impact that these games are having on your child so that the appropriate intervention can be made and long-term mental health issues can be avoided. It's about time somebody told these parents to parent, man. Jesus. I thought this was just great. Okay, I like, for the most part. Obviously, there were some parts in there that I did not agree with, but I'm just so goddamn glad, man, that there's a mainstream article where they're like, hey, by the way, video games really aren't the problem here. I hope you guys also enjoyed. If you did, make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you're brand new around here on my channel. Follow me over on Twitter at SubToOptimus. I post memes, thoughts, and updates over there. Surefire way to get notifications of all my newest content. Make sure to check out OpTube down below. I'll probably be streaming again tonight, so make sure to check that out here on my channel, guys. Thank you to my channel members. Your support helps my channel tremendously. And until my next video, guys, this is Optimus, glad to finally see some change with this kind of stuff, man, and signing out.